I'm Diane Rizignola with NAREIT. In conjunction with NAREIT's REIT Week, I'm here today with Owen Thomas, CEO of Boston Properties. Owen, how are you today?
Diane, I'm great. Thank you for having me this morning.
Boston Properties has been hard at work over the last 2 months, working on a health security plan aimed at repopulating the workplace. How did the company spring into action so quickly to put together such a robust plan?
It was clear to us, you know, pretty much at the outset of this crisis that we were going to come back to work one day. And given the presence of the virus, that health security was going to be top of mind for customers. So about, you know, 6 or 8 weeks ago, we formed a task force at Boston Properties across all of our regions. And it's run by our head of sustainability, Ben Myers. But we got professionals mainly in property management and engineering, but they really came from all departments and in all regions. And importantly, we also hired external medical experts. So Dr. Joe Allen from Harvard School of Public Health is part of our committee, because whatever solutions we came up with customers, we wanted them grounded in science. And so this committee deliberated for around a month and debated, you know, a whole host of topics. And then we created a health security, I would call it a strategic plan, because it doesn't specify for every building exactly what we're going to do, but it highlights all the high-level issues that we have to deal with. And we have sent it all to all our customers. We've had a town hall in each of our regions with all of our customers to get their feedback. You know, we view this as a important program that we're putting together for our customers. But we also posted the plan on our website, because this is all about everyone returning to work safely and, you know, not trying to have some kind of competitive advantage on your, you know, on your plans. And these, you know, the issues that that the customers and we are focused on is a number of things. You know, certainly first one is cleaning and disinfection of spaces. You know, how often, what kind of materials are used, who's doing it. You know, air recharge and filtering. So what kind of filtering systems are we using? Clearly, we're going to be recharging the air in the buildings much more frequently than we did in the past. Spacing. So how's the lobby going to look? What's the elevator going to be like? Screening and PPE. You know, you're going to see masks are going to be mandatory. There's going to be spacing in the elevators. And then, of course, communication. You know, what do we tell our customers about what's going on in the building, people that are infected, you know, what their risks are.
What are one or two changes that you feel office buildings must universally make heading into a post-COVID world?
I do think healthy building policies are going to be increasingly important. I mean, we were very focused on healthy buildings. It wasn't called health security at the time. It was called healthy buildings. And a lot of it is about light and air, but we were very focused on that. Improving customer productivity through those measures. And I think that will be more important. That will catch fire, you know, as a result of what's happening with the virus. And then I think it's more of a customer issue than our issue, but I think we're going to see more spacing. You know, there was a lot of densification going on in office real estate before the crisis. And there's during this return to work phase, there's going to be a lot less density. And my guess is when we stabilized in a new normal, there'll be less density in our office spaces. And new build-outs for new leases will have less density.
Boston Properties is focused in 5 markets: Boston, Los Angeles, New York, San Francisco, and Washington, D.C. How are you seeing coronavirus challenges differing on a regional basis?
There's some similarities, and there are actually some pretty material differences for all of our markets. So, you know, obviously our strategy is to be in the largest cities, and we think the most vibrant cities in the country. They happen to be on the coasts. And I would say that the local legislators have been pretty conservative as it relates to legislating, you know, stay-at-home orders around the virus. So, for example, in all 5 of our cities, we're still closed, whereas a lot of the country is already open. at this point in on May 21st. So that's number one. Number two, there were some differences in construction policies. So Washington, D.C. stayed open for construction throughout the COVID-19 pandemic so far, whereas in New York, Boston, and the Bay Area and L.A., construction was halted, you know, for some periods of time. So that was a big difference. You know, I do think one of the biggest differences is New York clearly was the hardest hit with the pandemic. You know, if you look at the infection rate, the deaths, it was definitely the hardest hit. And you can debate all kinds of reasons on why that was. But I do think, therefore, as a result, you know, our customers and employees in New York are most sensitive to health security and those types of things going forward. And then I do think a big change as we now prepare to go back to the office. At the end of the day, I'm pretty confident that leading edge, well-capitalized landlords are going to do a great job for their customers on health security. I think we'll do a great job, but I think others will as well. I think a big differentiator is going to be public transportation, because I think what workers are going to I think what's going to happen is that they're going to feel comfortable in their office space, but they're going to feel less comfortable getting to work, and particularly if it requires them to be in public transportation.
How will the pandemic change the demand for real estate in your sector?
So first is, because of the pandemic, we're in a recession, and it's, we don't know how deep that recession is going to be. It all depends on the course of the virus. You know, if we can come up with a solution and get rid of it sooner rather than later, it'll be a less bad recession. And if we can't, you know, the reverse. But whenever you have a recession, whether it's from a medical or a science event like we've had with the pandemic, or with, you know, an economic situation like under the GFC, you know, recessions are not great for real estate demand. So you've got, you know, companies are trying to cut costs. They're letting workers go. They're not taking more space. CEOs are more reluctant to invest the capital required to build out new offices. So it has a dampening effect on space demand. So that's number one. Now, look, recession is short term. And, you know, I'm confident that the U.S. economy will recover and we'll be back to a more typical growth environment, and rents will come back, and those types of things. But for the short term, the recession has an impact. The second is what I'd call the work from home phenomena. So, you know, these work from home tools were available to all of us for years before the pandemic. And then the pandemic hit and we all got put into this forced experiment of working from home as we're doing this interview. And I think we've all been kind of surprised on how well it's gone. You know, we've gotten our jobs done, we've done our reporting, we've gotten the blocking and tackling done and that kind of thing. But I'm hearing more and more from business leaders that, you know, it's, they wonder what's going to happen when we need to figure out how to grow our business, interface with clients and win. And I'm hearing, and I believe, that the virtual work is not an appropriate substitute for in-person work that occurs in an office. And then the third trend that I talked about earlier is spacing. You know, there was a big trend in office real estate for the last decade where companies were pressing more and more workers into smaller and smaller spaces to, I think, save costs. And it wasn't particularly popular, I didn't think, with the workers. And clearly with this pandemic, that trend is going to be reversed. And in the short term, it's definitely going to be reversed because you got to be 6 feet away from everyone. But even after the pandemic's over, my guess is spacing will go up and the density of workers in our office buildings will go down. And that will be a tailwind for office demand. So a lot of different factors, some short-term, some long-term, some hard to predict. But as always, in the real estate business, it's dynamic.
Owen, thank you so much for your time today.
Great, my pleasure. Thank you for having me. It's great to see you.
For more from REIT Week, visit REIT.com.